I'm for someone being able to take their health insurance with them when they change jobs. I'm for someone having coverage even for a pre-existing condition. You know, I am for doing something about the millions of dollars and those who can pay out of their pocket. I'm for doing something. I said all of that, and what made it into the story was I would have voted no on the health care bill, which is kind of a moot point at this point because you know, the Senate went in a different direction. But how could I vote for a bill that would saddle the state of Arkansas with $200 million in additional Medicaid expenses? We don't have any idea how we're going to pay for the increase we're going to have without that additional burden. So it would mean massive cuts in our state budget or big tax increases. How could I support that? So that was my point. The other point I wanted to make is if I had been in Congress at the time, I would have fought tooth and nail to get that out of the bill so we could have the 80% that we can all agree on. Nobody in the state legislature has done more to push for affordable access to quality care than I have. You know, our public health initiative we had last year that created a trauma system and supported community health centers and provided more support for in-home care for seniors and expanded the Our Kids First Children's Insurance Program. That was, you know, that's really the signature issue I had last session, and I'm going to push for that in Congress when I get there. But we can't take a federal problem and solve it by passing the bill down to the states.
Well, there it is, folks. You've heard from House Speaker Robbie Wills, a candidate for U.S. Congress. Mr. Speaker,